husband was sleeping with a 16-year-old.
Yeah. In my home, in my bed, while I sat. Yo.
Did you enjoy having sex with her?
No.
Oh. I didn't agree. Meet me after slashing your wrist, yeah. Or at the end if you so insist. I'm persisting when told to cease and desist. When it's blasphemous, yeah. Shit.
Kolochle, Kolochle. I had a message, I had a comment from Ashley Pass requesting we watch a 16-year-old surrogate who apparently stole a baby. I don't know how that works. How can a 16-year-old still a couple's baby? We're about to find out, but shout out Ashley. And she has a beard, or she used to have a beard of dragon, so we man them like that, you get me? So obviously gotta look after my people. Go grab yourself a nice cuppa. If you're American, make it, I guess, coffee. If you're English, nice cup of tea. If you're Turkish, cup of chai. Is that the same in China as well? That sounds familiar. Anyway, let's do this one. But I've got the double screen. I've just moved the screens over. But I haven't configured the thing. So it still thinks the other screen's there. So I'm having to go that way to control it up. I'm like Elon Musk on Twitter. Just working it out as I go along.
Our surrogate took off halfway through her pregnancy. I want our son to come home. We met our surrogate, Sarah.
I was homeless, and I didn't have a place to stay, and I had my two-year-old son with me.
And she told us she would carry a baby for us.
She just kept calling and asking me to go over to her house to have sex with her husband.
Well, the surrogate was 18 as far as we knew.
How old was she?
She was 16.
She told me to lie to everybody else that asked my age.
You're a lying little bitch!
What are you talking about?
You really have no legal rights to this child, then.
My husband does.
What? Lying.
Why am I lying?
You told us you were 18!
No, I didn't!
So your husband was sleeping with a 16-year-old?
Yeah, in my home, in my bed, while I sat in the living room.
Did you enjoy having sex with her?
No.
Oh. I didn't agree.
It's already... I was going to say, how can a 16-year-old steal a baby from a couple? How would she have that kind of life experience to be able to pull that off, that they would have to go on TV to try and get the baby? Like, already that wasn't mathing up. Like, but, yo, I could be wrong, but this is looking like already they've taken the piss and they have the audacity to come on TV and say, help us take the piss. That's my first impression. I could be wrong.
I have sex with him. So I felt like it was great.
What they did was wrong. You guys are perverts.
You wanted to have sex with a 16-year-old. You think you have rights to that child?
Of course I do. I'm father.
That is our baby.
The same time you were having sex with Derek, you were also having sex with your boyfriend.
Yes.
Her boyfriend is not the father of that child.
That's my child.
That's my son.
My guest is Dawn. Dawn, why are you here?
Steve, my husband and I are here because we want to see our son. Our surrogate took off halfway through her pregnancy, and we haven't seen her since. Our baby was born, and we've never even seen a picture of him. He's a month and a half old. I don't know what color his eyes are. I don't know what if he's got hair. I don't know if he's got all his fingers and toes.
And you're married?
Yes.
Your husband's name is?
Derek.
Okay, how long have you guys been married?
We've been married for 5.5 years.
And you're not able to have children of your own?
No, Steve, I had a hysterectomy 2 years ago, and so we can't have any children. My husband doesn't have any children of his own.
So you wanted to provide him?
We wanted to have a child together, and, you know, in... Sorry. In December... Through a mutual friend, we met our surrogate, Sarah. And we had been talking one day, and kind of jokingly told her that, you know, I was at the point where I'm willing to let my husband sleep with another woman just so we can have one. And we had taken her in off, basically off the streets at that point. She was living in her car. And she told us, well, she'd be willing to surrogate a baby for us. She would carry a baby for us because we were helping her. And my husband and I talked about it. Couple of days, and we decided, well, we're never going to have an opportunity like this again. So we drew up a contract. We all three signed that contract. And at that point, my husband and Sarah just started sleeping together. in my home, in my bed, while I sat in the living room.
How old was the surrogate?
Well, the surrogate was 18 as far as we knew, but we found out she lied to us.
How old was she?
She was 16.
So your husband was sleeping with a 16-year-old?
Yeah.
With your permission?
We didn't know she was 16. She lied to us. We didn't find out until maybe a week before we got confirmation of her pregnancy that she wasn't 18. But this whole incident almost destroyed...
Again, this is all first impressions of my ever, but if you hadn't seen... Sorry, but why am I apologizing to the fucking mic? I've been doing some sketchy stuff recently. If you hadn't heard them or seen them, how they project themselves, and you just heard the story, you'd automatically think, bruh, that dad's been manipulating the situation, got his wife to agree to let him bang someone else, blah, blah, blah. But then when you hear her talk and the way she's carrying herself and that little fraction I heard him talk, I'm the dad, he didn't appear the brightest. So it gives me more of the sense that she's the dominant one in the relationship. So then it kind of puts it in two situations. If she's the dominant one, did she want to have a baby to keep him? Because that was a very telling statement she said about he's never had a child. So was she wanting to have a baby to keep him, to stop him from leaving? Or has she got a bit of mental health issue and became obsessed with the thought of not being able to have another child, so that built up. You know, that is a couple of women that have done that, like one even cut baby out of a womb, like just as it was getting ready. You know, like she's sounding a bit possessive. So I'm more inclined to think she actually wants the baby as opposed to trying to keep her man. But again, I could be completely wrong. I could be just overanalyzed.
My marriage.
How old are you and him?
I'm 36, he's 30.
And I think this is the contract here. And the girl that you engaged, she agreed to engage in sexual intercourse with your husband for the sole purpose of conceiving. She was required to have intercourse at least once a day. And she's not, in the contract, not to have sex with anyone but your husband until she conceives, not engage in any risky behavior.
She voluntarily did all.
Yo, even if she's 18, yeah, cool, technically legal. Bro, between them, they're 66 years old. Talking to, this is why there needs to be more laws, and I'm sure they're bringing them in, about police, for example, having any kind of sexual interaction with someone in their custody, because they're in your custody. You have power, there's a power dynamic, so it's technically rape. There is no consent. Even if they consent, there's no consent because they are within your power. The girl is a little girl, 18 years old. They're both grown, big people. Looking at them, you'd even think they're older than the ages they said. They're bringing her in off the street. How is any of that fair? Already, that's a world, bro. That, what? And it's all, even if she's 18, this is sounding abusive, bro. This is sounding, what? That's mad coercive. And the way she's going on, I can imagine, like, oh, you might have to move. But once she'd agreed to it, she might have felt pressured into agreeing. That felt bad because they'd helped her. And it was probably their plan the whole fucking time as soon as they realised she was homeless. Move her in, make her. So once she agreed to it, I reckon they probably started putting that pressure on her. Say, well, you'll be back on the street then, man. Bro. I hope I'm wrong, man.
All of this, Steve.
Right, well.
Well, and she voluntarily lied to us because, you know,
conceive Carrie, give birth to the baby for you guys, and that only yours and your husband's name would appear on the birth certificate. No, she wants no custody or rights. Take care of herself during the pregnancy. And in return for her doing all this, you provide shelter.
Oh, shit. I've just realized. It's a fucking plot from My Name is Earl. They've literally watched the episode of My Name is Earl. Oh, my God. I've forgotten wife's name. What's her name? Oh, Brandy, Donnell, Joy. Joy, when Joy was going to have a baby, well, after having a fight with her black sister, they agreed Joy would surrogate. And then they drew up the contract and she weren't allowed to do this, that. And she had to... Bro. How could...
You're in your home for her for the duration... no less than 3 months after the birth. Provide Sarah with $50 spending money each month she's pregnant. So.
Yo! Yo! You nasty bastards. They've come on TV to say this, you know? They got that from My Name is Earl. Only someone with that kind of level of thinking would bring themselves on TV to complain. Do you give a grown adult who is going to be birthing your child $50 a month? No. You give a child $50 a month. Or you give an illegal immigrant. Those are the two that get exploited for pay. She's not an illegal immigrant. I fucking knew she was a child. That says it all. Same $50. And they wrote that down. So they're feeling like that's something good. And she's going to love that. She's rolling because she's a child.
So you have this contract. So what happened?
Well, everything moved really fast. She got pregnant right away. Got moved into a bigger home because we were living in a small house at that point. We started planning baby showers and we started planning the baby's name together. She even helped us finalize which name we were going to give the baby. And then she moved out and in August, boom, no more Sarah.
She disappeared.
She disappeared, took off with our son. And it's not right. She went back. She went to be with her boyfriend. They have a baby already together. And then he goes and signs our son's birth certificate.
How were you involved with Sarah's pregnancy?
I was involved with everything. I told her I wanted to be involved with everything. I took her to doctor's appointments. I was there for the first ultrasound. When she had cravings, I was getting cravings. I had the morning sickness right along with her. I was at a Halloween party. I started getting pains in my stomach. I told my husband we had to go home. She gave birth that day.
And?
We didn't find out until a couple of weeks later when I found the newspaper article for the birth announcement saying that Aaron and Sarah had given birth to this beautiful baby boy.
At some point, did you break off contact?
She left our home in June. And never came back.
And why did she leave?
I honestly couldn't tell you.
She said, I'm leaving, and...
Yeah, she moved out. She said everything was fine with us. You know, the baby's still coming home. So we didn't...
And then now, since the baby's been born, what kind of contact has there been since? None.
She and Aaron will not return our texts or our phone calls or our emails.
Have you ever met your son?
No, I've never even seen a picture of him.
And I'll say that because you say he's your son.
No, he is my son.
Okay.
She's never even sent us a picture of him.
So you don't even know what he looks like?
No. Never
met him? What are you hoping happens today on the show?
I want our son to come home. I want, you know, if we have to share with Sarah, that's fine, but she needs to...
She don't need
She needs to realize that my husband is the father of this baby, and she needs to let us have bonding time with him because we've already lost six
now,
weeks.
Let me ask you this. Knowing that now she took off before she gave birth, obviously she had this boyfriend still in her life that she put her boyfriend and her name on the birth certificate. Really, what hope do you have that this baby will ever be in your life?
You know what? Her boyfriend is not the father of that child.
But how do you know?
Because he lived in a different town when she conceived him. Because the dates line up for the conception from the due date.
Knowing that she did all this to you, took off, didn't put your name, knowing that she did all this, you know, is it possible that maybe she was screwing around on the side?
You know what? You know what? Anything is possible, but until I have proof that that is not my husband's baby, that is our baby.
Okay. I just want to point out and make this clear, because I read this contract and you provided this contract, that this contract has no force or effect. I believe it was entered in with
a minor,
so right there would make the contract invalid.
She is emancipated, which makes it not invalid.
But this Jerry is just Lewis. A contract between the two of you.
It
There's
is.
No legal binding, and I don't even know if surrogacy is even legal in the state that you're from. You really have no legal rights to this child, then.
My husband does. That's his son. And it is a federal...
But it's not
it's a crime
it's
for
not,
it's a crime
proven.
To knowingly lie on
it's
identity.
It's not proven.
It's not proven, but we want to prove it.
Okay, but she could say, no, this is my man. It's his child, and too bad. You know what I mean?
But you know what? I don't care what her age is. She knew what she was doing when she signed this contract.
Okay, let's say it like this, and I understand you're very emotional about it, and you entered into something that you really don't even know the person. You didn't, it's not like you got into it. Did you even ask for her ID when you did this contract? I mean, if you would have took simple steps to say, okay, we're going to get into this pretty serious contract. Maybe we should go to a lawyer. Let's all put our cards on the table. This is who we are.
Man, you don't do that shit. When you're going to buy drugs, you don't have police escort you. You just hope the drug dealer doesn't fucking rob you. But if they rob you, what can you do? You know you're doing something wrong. She knew she was doing something wrong. That's why I can't believe this stunt now. That's how she cares zero about the man. Her man. The perv. Even though she set it up, he still fucked a child. So he's a fucking nonce. But feels like she's so obsessed with getting a child, she doesn't care. She's throwing him under the bus, bringing him on TV to show that he fucked a child. In a 0.00000% chance that she's going to get that child. I've made a lot of assumptions.
So we are, you know, we're going to fund a... No, you didn't do any of that. You and your husband, you know, you drew up a little piece of paper here. And you didn't even know how old the girl was. You didn't even know who she was. She could have said, you know, her name's anything, and you wouldn't have known. I'm saying...
But we met her through a family friend, so when they told us that she was 18, I had no reason to believe that this friend would lie to us.
Listen, you'd go through more paperwork and more identification.
She's already said that she doesn't care about the
age.
She literally blurted it out.
I mean...
That was literally the statement of a paedophile. I don't care about the age. They knew what they were doing. She literally said that.
We're talking about a homeless minor here.
We didn't know she was a minor. I don't ask for an ID from everybody I meet to make sure that they're the age they say
they are. If they're gonna carry your baby and they're gonna live in your house, yeah.
Well, you know what? Hindsight being what it is.
Not hindsight, no. This is not hindsight. How well did you know this girl?
Not well.
Okay, there you go. You didn't know this girl well, but you entrusted this person to bring a child into the world for you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not in hindsight, just bad decision making. You know it, I know it.
You know, I can agree that it was bad decision making.
bad decision making, but not for the reason he said.
It happened. We can't change it. And now she needs to do what's morally right in the least and let us see my husband's son.
You're saying what's
she
morally right.
She said morally.
Do you think it's morally right for her to keep
what I
morally.
Think is morally right is that two people of the age of 36 and 30 took a minor homeless girl in to have a baby with her. And, you know.
The audacity.
You know, and a 30-year-old sleeping with, okay, you say she was 18. But you never took the time to find out if she really was.
But even if she was.
So we're going to bring out the mother that carried this child, supposedly for you, but changed her mind, decided to keep the child, and let's find out what she has to say. Her name is Sarah. Let's bring her out.
You know what, Sarah? You're a lying little bitch.
What are you talking about? I told you I was 16 when I first
asked. Yo, yo. Yo,
you're a lying little bitch. You're a...
First of all, the aggression is the 150th red flag this woman has shown. And secondly, she looks like a fucking child. Even at 18, how can you feel comfortable? Bro, what is it? Them Pearl and them man them say they want young and pure. Bro. Nah, bro. Think about all the things she said. Imagine it coming out of the mouth of a known predator. Imagine it coming out of the mouth of R. Kelly.
I don't care about the age. She knew what she was doing.
Changes the dynamic a little bit.
What are you talking about?
Backstabber.
I'm a backstabber?
You know
I'm
what?
A backstabber?
You
need a fucking child.
My husband sat there and enjoyed it.
You need to take it back with you and Aaron, and you need to give us our side.
Yeah, I ain't giving you.
You know what?
He is my
son. No, he is your son. He is my son.
Yeah,
he is mine.
You just sat there.
I have proof of this.
Sat on the damn couch.
Hold on. Dawn, I'm going to ask you to leave the stage. I'm going to talk to Sarah and we'll bring you back.
She's a baby. She is a baby.
Why don't you have a seat? So I see the story. Dawn comes on the show and produces this contract that they produced between you and her and her husband.
She's a baby, and this happened. This started like a year and a half before this.
Yes, I told him when she first asked me.
The first time she asked you how old you were, you said
I was 16.
Arrest the bitch.
She knew you were 16.
Arrest the fucker. Arrest both of them.
She turned around and told me to lie to everybody else that asked my age to say I was
18. Oh, she asked you to lie to everybody.
Yes.
Yeah, I know she did. I know she fucking did.
Lying.
Why am I lying?
You told us you were 18!
No,
you told us you were 18!
No.
Of course they're fucking lying. They've got no self-awareness. They're coming on TV attacking a child and trying to pull some moral high ground. Bro, arrest them. He's done a crime. They both done a crime because she instigated it. So that's culpability, you know? So they're both going, they should both get the same sentence.
And she wanted you to go over to her house for what purpose?
To have sex with her husband.
She's saying, hey, Sarah, come over and have sex with my husband.
No, she was sitting there saying, why don't you come over and we'll smoke a little pot and whatnot and hang out and talk and everything else.
Drugging her now.
And yes, I did agree to do the turkey baster. But then... her husband.
That's fucking L. I told you. That was my name is L. Bro. Oh my fucking God.
They sat down and watched My Name is L. That is how Elle convinced Joy to go along with it. She's playing the role of Joy. Except Joy was a grown-ass fucking woman who already had two kids. And then Elle goes around with a turkey baster.
Bro, let me demonstrate. And he actually has a
turkey. He's like,
I'm laughing because it's fucking hilarious, but they're fucking predators and they need to go to prison. But America's dumbest criminals? How are they doing this? Bro, it's like they robbed a jewelry store. They robbed a jewelry store. Their house got burgled and went to the police to report that some of the jewels went missing. Fucking hell. And they drugged her. And they say immoral, you know. Bro, I've asked my kids what they want for dinner and they've changed my mind by the time the plates come out.
Her husband turned around and said...
Wait, hold. What is the turkey pasta mean?
Like... He sits there and ejaculates into a condom and then they get that turkey baster, squeeze it out, and then inject it into me.
Did you agree to the turkey baster?
Yes, I did. And then she turned around and told her husband that... She turned around and told her husband that I did agree with her about that. And then he turned around and he said, well, this is going to be my baby. I want some part of it. I'm not going to do the turkey baster. I want to have sex with her.
Why did you, when they brought this to you, you agree to it, or?
I didn't agree to have sex with him, no. I told her I'd have to think about it, and then I just kept ignoring her phone calls. She sat there.
But eventually, at some point, you agreed to it?
I agreed to it because she knew I didn't have a place, and I had my two-year-old kid. I didn't have a job, I had no money, no nothing, and I was homeless. And I loved my son very much, and I want to do anything I possibly can just to support him.
So... But you were feeling pretty awkward about having to sleep with Don's husband.
Every time that I would end up sleeping with him, I could not even look at him. I ran out of the house crying every time we were done. He kept asking me to see if it felt good. And one time when she left, he sat there and he was like, well, would you ever come back to me non-business and have...
See, she's not even saying that much, but what she's saying sounds very sincere. Like, she wouldn't have needed to mention the turkey baster. She could have just said the sex part. So that kind of added weight to the story. But regardless of all of that, that's an irrelevant subject. The words she's saying, the woman has already incriminated both of them anyway. Like, the woman has pretty much sent them two to prison. Surely. Especially if they do some sort of... Oh, fuck's sake. Well, it doesn't matter. The test doesn't matter. Okay, I got worried then for a second. So hopefully, yeah, it's cool. We don't need the baby to be his to prove that he had sex. They've already admitted it. They've openly admitted it. So, cool. That is a crime. But now she just said a couple words that just resonated a bit more. With America especially, unlike England, if someone's murdered someone in England and they get caught and charged and blah, 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 they normally get done for like murder or manslaughter. And that'll be it, essentially. But in America, and I'm sure you all know this, having watched so much crime programs over the last few years, in America, they charge you for every part of the crime. That's part of the reason why their sentences are so vile. So, like, if you rob a shop, if there's people in the shop, you get done for the robbing of the shop. If you use the weapon, you get done for the weapon. If there's people in the shop, you get done for kidnapping. Do you get what I mean? So, with that kind of context, she's saying, her words just added weight and made me realise that, yo, what they did was essentially force her into prostitution.
He forced a minor into prosecution. Prosecution. I've got prosecution on my mind. They better get prosecuted. They forced a minor into prostitution. That's fucking wild. And didn't the other lady, can't even call her a lady, didn't the other woman mention something about someone was living out of state? Was it the fella? So if at one time she went to the fella and they picked her up, that's bringing a minor across state lines for the purposes of, so there's bare charges, you know. Like, they can be getting 20 to 40 years for this show. I hope, is there any way to find out?
Non-business and have sex with me again?
For the purpose other than having a child, would you have sex with me?
Yes.
So you're saying he was enjoying having sex with you?
Yes.
In your mind, do you know he knew he was having sex with a 16-year-old?
Yes, he knew. Okay. I told him in front of her.
And then you did get pregnant?
Yes.
Were you sleeping with anybody else at the time?
Yes.
Who were you sleeping with?
My boyfriend.
Your boyfriend. So you were having sex with Dawn's husband, but at the same time, as you're saying, you were having sex with your boyfriend.
Yes, because
why are the audience groaning like this isn't a little girl?
I was hoping it would go away.
Okay. What did your boyfriend say about you having sex? I mean, obviously he knew or he didn't know?
He kind of did, but not really. I told him what was going on and everything else, and he didn't like it, but then after I had the baby and everything, he wants to be the father. And so I let him sign the birth certificate.
And as you say, possibly be his baby too.
Yes.
Did you ever enjoy having sex with him?
So, I felt like it was
wait, what the? The boyfriend knew? Is this a decent proposal? What circumstance can you allow you? Sorry, partners are not possessions. Cool, I don't mean to sound like that. But in what circumstance are you gonna be okay with your partner fucking someone else? Obviously, again, it shows how young they are. But he looked a bit older than her, the boyfriend, in the clips they show. But regardless, a 15-year-old knows someone shouldn't be fucking a partner. So where was he living? He's allowing his girl to... Nah. And even what she just said there, he wanted to be on it. She didn't sound on it. Am I lying? She did not sound enthusiastic. She wasn't fighting for her man. Because her man weren't fucking fighting for her, bro. Wow. So her man's Woody Harrelson. And the other guy's Robert Redford. This poor fucking girl, man. Everyone's letting her down. And where's her actual... Why was she... Ugh. It sounds like... I'm focused so much on that actual thing. Her life's fucked anyway. She's 16, she's homeless. Like, why... This boyfriend needs to have a good fucking explanation. Sorry. I can't imagine what the fuck he can say to... flip this around. Ugh, poor girl. And she looks like a baby. And this is happening. The baby's a couple months old at least. 9 months for the pregnancy. However long to try. If she looks that young now, how old did she look a year and a half ago?
But you did do it willingly.
I did agree to it because I wanted to have a roof over my kid's head.
You
did
it fuck.
So you'd have a place to stay, a place to take care of your son. They were feeding you,
yes,
giving you some money.
They never gave me money.
They never gave you money.
They didn't even give her the $50.
Not even according to the contract, the $50 a month and spending money.
No.
They never gave you anything.
No.
Just a question. I got to ask it. Instead of moving in with them, how come you just didn't go be with your boyfriend?
Because he ended up moving out of his hometown to go somewhere else for a job.
Do you believe that the baby you had is Derek's?
No.
You believe that it's your boyfriend's?
Yes.
What are you hoping happens today?
That they'll leave me alone.
You want them to leave you alone?
I want my life back.
You want your life back. We offered to give you a DNA test to prove, you know, between your boyfriend and Derek, and you refused. And why did you refuse?
Because no matter what, I'm still going to love my kids. I love them anyways. I will do anything for them. And honestly, I really do believe that he is Aaron's.
You wanted to have sex with a 16-year-old. You think you have rights to that child?
Of course I do. I'm the father.
What they did was wrong. You guys are perverts.
That's my child.
That's my son.
How old are you now?
17.
You're 17. We're bringing out Derek. Let's bring out Dawn's husband, Derek, who you were sleeping with.
You're double D's, yeah?
Why are you lying?
Why am I lying? You said that you liked it. When your wife left, you told me that if I would ever business and
you're
have
lying
sex
about
with
everything.
You. And how was that, huh?
You're lying about how old you
No,
told.
I told you to.
Bull.
No,
you
I
told
did
us
not.
You were 18.
No, I didn't.
And you're the one
I
that
told
offered
I was
it.
16. I sat there and said, Bull. I wanted to do it to her. No.
The wife said
it
was the wife's
idea. With her.
No.
Suck yourself.
Bull. We gave you the option of the turkey baster or the intercourse.
And I told you no. And you still did it.
Forever. We didn't anything. You didn't want.
You guys called me and called me. And I told you I did not want nothing to do with it.
Bull.
I told you. And you guys still pressured me and everything else.
How did we pressure you?
Okay, hold on a sec. How come you didn't do the turkey baster?
One, because I smoke pot. That lowers your sperm count. Two is because I wanted to be a part of the child's, you know, development.
Now, I know this is going to be incredibly hard to do, okay? This might be one of the toughest things that you're ever going to have to do in your life. But I want you to imagine you and me are in a bar, and we're having a cold beer, okay? But it's just you and me. They're not here. Why didn't you want to do the turkey baster?
Because.
Remember, two cold beers, just you and me.
You know, it's the natural thing to do. I mean, do you do it in a turkey baster way?
No, I never done a turkey baster. But then again, I'm not having sex with 16-year-olds.
I didn't know she was 16. I wouldn't have had sex with her if I knew she was 16.
I mean, okay, Derek, I tried to give you a way to, you know, just to come out and say it. And you should say it because nobody is going to believe the natural act or whatever you were saying. You know, I must be smoking pot if I believe that story. You wanted to have sex with a 16-year-old.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No. My wife has kids around her age. I would have never had sex with her if I knew she was 16. We made a mistake. We took her for her word.
You took her for her word. You went into a contract. You typed up this contract, agreeing to all these things that she had to do, that you were going to do, and you didn't even ask for a form of identification.
No.
Okay.
She looked 18. She told us she was 18.
Well, that's good enough for you.
It should be good enough for anybody.
No. No, bro.
Why would people lie?
A 30-year-old... There you go. Excellent question. I never thought of that. Why would people lie? Why would people lie, right? So I'm going to ask you a question. Did you enjoy having sex with her?
No.
Now you know the answer to your question. So now you're gonna enter into a contract with this young girl who says she's 18, and why would she lie? And you don't ask for an ID. Did you ask anything about her medical history?
No.
So you're gonna have a baby with a woman, you don't know how old she is, you don't know her medical history. Did he ask you, I don't know, just random, got herpes, any epilepsy, cancer, you know, anything. But you didn't ask one of these questions.
No.
Even, like, he's saying now, like, he just picked up a woman off the street to get her pregnant.
Or was it the sex?
A homeless person. I need to stress again that I'm far from a violent person. These are all obviously extreme cases, but I couldn't be a host of a show like that because he kept saying triggering shit that deserved a clap as soon as he said it, you know? Like, he wasn't even trying to make sense. There was too many times when he gave an answer and he just deserved something straight back in the jaw. 100%. Fucking disgusting. Look how greasy he looks, like. Fucking poor girl, man. And there's the boyfriend allowed, like, again, obviously, she's not his position, but forget all that. He allowed that to happen. I thought it was like a new boyfriend, but I wasn't even clocking that. But when he asked her directly, did he know? Fuck him. As soon as she said that, fuck him. Fuck him. He went up, he swung off to some next place for a job and left his missus homeless with a baby. Fuck him. And he wants to claim this baby. Fuck him.
So when you were having sex with her, what was your thought process? What was going through your mind?
Get in and out.
See what I'm saying?
Oh, the bedroom or?
How would you not bang that as soon as he said that?
Get it done and get it over with.
And that was it?
That was it.
No enjoyment whatsoever?
No.
How were you able to get aroused?
Sex. I mean, come on, Steve. You know.
Yeah, come on, Derek. Okay, you're in a bedroom with this attractive young 16-year-old.
He still doesn't realize he's a pedo.
And you're not thinking, oh, man. And not
he's
only
not
that,
getting it.
You're getting a free pass. Your wife is saying, yeah, go in that bedroom and go have sex with her.
And I did. I went into this for the sole purpose of having a child of my own. That is it.
And you would not do the turkey baster. Because you could have got a child that way.
Maybe.
But you didn't try.
No, we didn't try.
Because you said, I want to have the sex.
I said I wanted to be a part of the conception of the baby.
Which either way, turkey baster or sex, you would have had either way. All right, do you really believe that you're the father of her child?
Yes.
And why do you believe that?
Because the time lines up, and I know Aaron ain't the father.
How do you know that?
Because they weren't even dating at the time.
Well, she was sleeping with him.
She was sleeping with somebody else, not Aaron.
Well, then maybe that guy could be the father.
Doubt it.
Why?
Because
why?
Because they weren't supposed to be sleeping with each other.
Yeah, they weren't supposed to, but you just said they were.
No, she was dating somebody else at the time.
Okay, and she's saying she was sleeping with somebody else at the time.
I just have that feeling that it is my child.
So you think you have rights to that child?
Of course I do. I'm the father.
Oh. You look so grubby, man.
Your wife brought up the point that morally, that she should do the morally right thing and give this baby to you and your wife. That's what your wife said, not me. But do you think it's morally right that as a 30-year-old grown man that you took advantage of a homeless teen, whether she's 16 or 18, she was a homeless teenage girl, and you didn't even ask for identification or took her to a doctor. Let's say, not even ask her about her medical history. How about a simple checkup? Take her to the doctor and have a doctor examine.
He doesn't give a fuck. He's thinking I better hurry up before my wife changes her mind.
Let's take her and get a checkup. Did you do that?
No.
And why didn't you do that?
Because we didn't think about it.
All you thought about was...
You know why? And I'll ask you this. How many women have you had sex with that you took and had a checkup with? None.
None.
And she's including that list. So maybe that's why. It wasn't so seriously, ooh, I want a child and I don't want to do the turkey baster because I really want to be involved in the process. And, you know, I'm so concerned about this child, but I'm not going to get doctors involved or... Even a high school ID will give me some proof of how old she is. I'm just going to have sex with her and hope for the best. Your boyfriend's here? And just so Derek hears this from your mouth, the same time you were having sex with Derek, you were also having sex with your boyfriend?
Yes.
Okay. Let's bring your boyfriend out.
He looks nearly 30 himself.
Drunk. You know how old she was?
Bull. Really?
I had plenty of time with her.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
That's my child.
That's my son.
Get your asses off my stage.
Ashley, what did you make me watch, man? Oh, he's a nasty bastard. He looks the same age as the other guy. He looks the same age
as the other guy. You believe that your father, and knowing that she was in a very tough position.
Yeah, she was in a really terrible position.
You can see on her face, this isn't something that she enjoyed. She felt like it was her only option. And
she did what she could to
And your feeling about this whole situation with Derek and Dawn.
I'll be back.
With your girlfriend.
Gorgeous, you all right? Yeah.
You haven't
done
my
I'll do it right now. Sorry, gorgeous. I'll do it right now.
Yeah, okay.
All right, get to sleep, gorgeous. Love you.
Yeah, love you, bye.
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 I'm back. Has my daughter telling me off because she asked me to do something for her earlier. I was like, yeah, cool. Something financial. And I was like, yeah, cool. But she knows me, like, I forget everything. It's weird, I have selective memory. Like when I write songs, and like when I'm writing raps for myself, I never write the shit down. I can write whole songs. Like, I think the longest I've written is about, I think I wrote a 64 bar all in my head, just walking around in circles, just writing. But then I forget what I'm going to get the moment I stand up. This girl's been let down by everyone in this story. And that's not because she's a girl and blah, blah, blah. It's nothing to do with that. This is a person, a young person, and all these fucking adults are fighting over this person. Like she doesn't even fucking exist. And what this person can do for them, not one of them gives a fuck about her. Even this guy that's just come out now, he doesn't care about her. He's come out talking about the baby, bro. The baby that he didn't mind.
What's your feelings on it?
What they did was wrong. You guys are perverts. Go after girls, young girls, to have babies with you. You could have went out there and adopted a baby. Oh, maybe you couldn't. That's why you went that way. Do it under the law. But guess what? I'm stepping in. You're not.
That's my child.
That's my son.
No, it's not. It's
yes,
mine.
Yes, he is. He's my son.
No, it's my son.
Oh, hell, he is it's... not.
You left her.
No, I went find another job.
Oh.
I'm a working man, not you like left you. Her, stay bro. Home.
I work what are they clapping for?
To support my family.
Because he works.
I do whatever it takes. That's how I was raised. That's how I'm going to die.
Let's bring your wife back out.
First of all, Aaron, how dare you sign my son's birth certificate?
No,
you're nothing
he's my
but a
son.
Piece of
you're
support your own son.
Get shorter.
When your girlfriend was living in my house.
He's my son.
You want this
I don't have to.
This
my
is the
son.
NBA test. If it's not there,
so
baby,
don't
leave
it's
the hell alone.
Know.
And you know what? It is a federal crime.
Yeah, you're
they
looking
know
for
it
30 years.
On
you're
a birth certificate. So I will be pursuing that.
Go
you
for it.
Audacity.
You know what? This is
the audacity. If she went to a dealer, or if she was out and if she was out in Party Central, there in a town, so that's probably a pub on the corner, and some man come up and offered her a bit of sniff, and she paid for it, and then went to the bathroom and realised it was talcum powder, she would go to the police. She would go to the fucking police. The only mature one in this whole thing is the fucking child. She's presenting herself maturely. She's keeping herself contained. She's defending herself. She did whatever she had to do for her child. While these adults are... And even if dude is the same age as that, he skipped out of town. It was her and the child. If you take them all risk over now, and you knew about the thing.
You want me living for 30 years.
I'll see you back home.
Behind bars.
Yeah, but you want to be living in
ours.
It's going to be done
get the hell out of
after ours. This show. Wait,
you on, do the DNA on, test.
No
if that's not there,
no
DNA
test.
Hold on a second.
You guys aren't showing a lot of sympathy for them, okay? I mean, come on now. Being a little too tough on them.
He knows what's coming. She doesn't.
What it boils down to, and it boils down to a lot of things, but there's dumb and dumber.
You know what? I take offense to that. I take offense to that. That is so rude.
Wait, hold on. You just said you take offense to that because
I
it's
I
it's
don't
so
appreciate
rude.
Being called dumb.
You don't appreciate being called dumb.
How
you
about
know
pedo?
What? I made a mistake. Have you ever not made a mistake? Are you perfect?
Have you
is
ever
anybody
not
here
made
perfect?
A mistake?
We oh, made a mistake.
I love this.
I doubt you're
I
perfect,
this.
Ma'am.
When you take advantage of a 16-year-old and you sleep with her and she's homeless, I made a mistake. Nobody's perfect. Nobody's perfect. You've slept with 16-year-olds, haven't you? I'm driving down the street after the show, and I have like a bologna sandwich. I'm trying to entice. I'm trying to entice homeless girls into the car. Hey, you hungry? So I had my little fun for this show. I had my little fun. But I'll say this, and this is the good part of the show. We get to expose people on this show. We get to expose them for what they are. And you two pathetic, despicable human beings on my stage.
It's only just starting to dawn in on him.
Speak about
she's still not
reality and doing the right thing, and she should give her child to you, and this is the right thing to do. You two predators preyed on a young girl in one of the weakest moments of her life, being homeless, and you want a child, you don't ask for an ID or take her to a doctor's appointment. All you are concerned with, you and your fantasy land world in your head, thinking that you're somehow gonna walk away with a child with this, and him getting everything that he wanted, sex with a young girl. So that's what you got. What did you come here for? The Steve Wilco show is gonna help you take her child away from her and give to you two knuckleheads? This is what we do know. She's the mother. We know that for sure. She's mom. And as far as I'm concerned, you're dad.
Thank you.
And if I was, if I was able to do it.
Trust me.
Legally.
Trust me.
I'd throw you off my stage physically. But I can't do that, so for now, get your asses off my stage. I hope all your hard times are over.
I hope so.
Getting these people out of your life, I think maybe that'll happen now. Going forward, knowing you are a young mother of two, if we can help with anything that we can offer as far as counseling, parenting classes, helping with the needs of your child, we certainly would like to help with that. But also now, you are with her.
Yes.
Young woman, you have two children with her, and I know both of you are young, but you need to stick together now.
That's
and not let predators come into your life and take advantage of you, take advantage of her, and certainly never take advantage of your children. Do the best that you can, and if you need help with your children, if you need help, and I understand, being young, especially as you are, and being in that situation, you need to reach out and get help, but don't reach out to the creeps in the world. Reach out to the people that really want to help you. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Good luck. Who's going to help? Ashley, man. I respect Steve because I could see the story. He wasn't happy with the dude either, but it wasn't that story, so he just allowed it. The only person he cared for was the girl, and rightly so. Even if he is young, but it's when she said he knew, that just, from that point, I just switched off of him. You can't make up for that. You can't make up for that. You can't. You can't. How could you ever look your partner in the face, like... Either one of you, doesn't matter who did it. If the other one actually allowed their partner or was able to sit down while their partner went out and gave their body away to keep her child alive, essentially. And now he's doing the grandiose whole thing, coming out acting like, you weren't doing that for the 9 months. It's mad. Am I being harsh? I don't know. Maybe I'm being harsh. I don't know. of that poor girl. And I'm surprised Steve didn't mention nothing about prosecution, because the woman was more than happy to keep flinging out them words, but legally she confessed to entrapment, to coercion, to prostitution. How many other crimes did they admit to? Anyway, let me know if you have any other suggestions. Yeah, I appreciate that, Ashley. Oh, Ashley, while we was watching this, you actually commented on something. Kilojle. It's Yoruba. Nigerian. And I'm not even Yoruba. I found out not long before my dad died that I'm Hausa. But I always knew the word Kilojle, which is basically just, what's up? That's all it is. What's up? Kilojle. In the same language, bye is bye. Doesn't quite have the same ring. But yeah, till the next time.